Alright, hello. That would lead me to believe it's working. I can hear my own keyboard. Almost loaded the wrong save there. Okay, we're good. I didn't think I was actually typing for that long, but whatever. Anyway. Alright, let's get cracking. This is actually quite loud. Let me turn this down a second. Gears and, I've been playing Gears of War recently in, Advanced Warfare, which is really, really good. Like, man, I haven't enjoyed a Call of Duty that much in a long, long time. I really, really enjoyed Advanced Warfare. I've been playing those recently, and they seem, fairly quiet games. What's this? Shotgun ammo? I don't need that. Yeah, I don't need that shit. But, yeah. Like, man, Advanced Warfare was super good. So good, in fact, that I'm gonna write up a piece about that for my blog later. Which the first one went... first one in a long time. I actually went live the other day. No, it was yesterday. Was it today? Man, I can't even remember. It's been super busy these past few weeks with, you know, Christmas and work and all this shit and traveling. It's been very, very busy. These guys are super eager today, aren't they? But, yeah, so I put up a little thing about Gears 4. Mainly the thoughts on the campaign. It's not been that long since I stopped playing Gears, so I don't really think I'm going to go back to the Gears 4 multiplayer at all. Especially after the beta. Like, it's not bad, you know. But, oh, that was pretty cool, actually. Okay, that's a tough guy. But yeah, it's not bad by any means, but who the fuck just shot me? I always forget about the guy up here. Yeah, it's definitely not bad. It's actually fantastic, but I'm just not... I haven't had enough time away from, you know, Gears 4, Gears multiplayer to really miss it. You know, I only really stopped playing it a couple of years ago. And I played a lot of Gears multiplayer. I got pretty good at Gears for the most part, you know. I was pretty good at that game. And, whereas Halo, you know, I had quite a long time away from Halo. So I had time to miss Halo. Not really the case for Gears. So yeah, I put up a little thing about that. Just kind of my thoughts on the campaign. I'll probably do a follow-up one, because I'm currently going through it on Insane solo. And man, that game is a spectacularly broken pile of shit on Insane when you play it by yourself. You can tell that's meant to be played co-op on the higher modes. And yeah, Insane is rough. It's not fun by any stretch of the imagination. It's just really broken, which is a shame. I feel Gears 4 has been heading... Gears, in general, I think, has been heading that way since 2. Gears 1, I think, was the only one where the Insane mode was actually, you know, balanced if you wanted to play it on your own. And I feel like since then, it's just been, oh, well, you know, people are going to play this with another person, so fuck it. You know, everything kills you in 3 hits. That's cool, right? Right? Like, no. No, it isn't. That's not cool at all. Because you have to dump, like, half a magazine into every goddamn enemy to kill them. 3/4 of a magazine if your bullets aren't on active reload. which is no exaggeration for Gears 4, by the way. Trust me, that's not me, you know, being hyperbolic. Even the grunt enemies take about 3/4 of a Lancer magazine to kill.
Like you, I'm American.
Which is fucking ridiculous, you know? Like, that's not fun. If I wanted that, I'd play Halo Firefight. You know? But, I digress. But yeah, like, overall though, it's still really fun. I just wish I had people to play it with. You know, like, my usual group of Gears people, you know, we've since kind of lost touch, which is a shame. And I don't really play, you know, that much multiplayer with people I know anymore. Because just, you know, the schedules and such are always so different that we're rarely free at the same time. So I haven't had people to play Horde mode yet with, which is annoying, because playing Horde on your own is just... Everyone leaves, you know, everyone just leaves the games. It's super frustrating. So I haven't really had time to dive into that yet. Oh dear! I knew it! I was pressing the wrong button first, and then... Like, that seems like a really strict button mashy one. It probably doesn't help that I really wasn't paying attention through that. I was actually trying to sort out this audio. Anyway, should probably continue. So, that's that. But, I love that they give you this checkpoint, though. That's nice. But, yeah, I kind of want to play more Advanced Warfare. I really do. Like, man, that game was fun. Not really interested in playing the multiplayer. I might, like, briefly dive into it. Like, who knows? I mean, after 2 years of... You know, that game's been out 2 years, and I've never been a Call of Duty multiplayer guy, so I'll probably just get absolutely slaughtered if I play the multiplayer. But, you know, there's the co-op there, there's zombies mode, so I could try that. But more than that, what impressed me was the campaign. That campaign was awesome. It was so... It just felt so, you know, like, tightly crafted. There we go. You get the really long pause if you actually do it right. But yeah, it just felt so tightly crafted and really, really... varied, you know? You are very rarely ever doing the same thing twice in that campaign. You know, from any one mission, you know, it's got the usual kind of Call of Duty campaign beats, you know. You'll be going through, like, you know, you'll be going through various corridors and shooting various people in the face with various guns, with various red dot sights on them. That's all par for the course. But the environments you do it in are really cool. The movement aspect of it is awesome. Like, I think that's the biggest part of why it felt so fresh. You know, the boost, the double jump, the slides, the exosuit abilities are really cool. They really freshen up that game in a way that I think it's needed for a long time. And the last Call of Duty I played, by the way, was Modern Warfare 3, which was, I think, 2011. So it's been a good 5 years since I played a Call of Duty. And going back to it and having just all these new abilities, the speed at which they do it, I think they kind of freshen up the weapons really nicely. Being able to kind of cycle grenades and throw them in different types was a really nice touch. The exosuit upgrades are pretty cool. Not all that important, but, you know, it's nice to have. And the way it kind of affects the HUD, too. Like, the HUD's really minimalistic. It's almost Dead Space-esque. Like, your grenades appear along the, barrel of your gun. Like, how many you have. Your ammo counter is just, like, behind the hammer where your gun is. It's really cool. You know, it lets you just focus on shooting dudes in the face, which that game makes incredibly fun. And, you know, the melee is really cool in that game. It's not the traditional knife to the grill in the other games. Like, you just have this, like, amazing punch animation where you just, like, punch people and they go flying. You know, you punch dudes, like, 20 feet across the room. it's really, really cool. So I'm looking forward to going back through that. That was a really fun campaign. And there's some good stealth stuff in there, too. I really like the... Usually stealth missions in Call of Duty are pretty much go prone and shoot people with silenced weapons. The stealth stuff in this game is a bit more varied than that and really, really interesting. And there's some really cool stuff late in the game with mechs and vehicles. Like, it just... I don't know. Like, to me, I don't really see why more people didn't talk about that game when it was out. It seemed like that game kind of came out and was like, eh, you know, another Call of Duty game. Yeah, like, I thought it was fucking awesome, so I don't really see why it's kind of done that. You know, I don't know, it probably did well. It's Call of Duty, they always do well. But, I felt that really freshened that up, you know, and that's not the kind of impression I got from people that I know, at least, that played it. Okay, my rifle's exclusive. Oh, hey, Immortal, what's up, dude? That's no problem, man. Don't worry about it. They're always on YouTube if you want to catch them. But yeah, I haven't been streaming that much lately. God, yeah, work is very, very busy right now. So it's like work. I'm currently getting my full driving license sorted. So hang on a minute, 367. Okay, so we'll get rid of that. Oops. Damn it, I still need more space. Hang on, there's no more regenerators, so I can just sell that. But yeah, currently getting that done, which is really cool. That's eventually I want to start doing racetrack days on a motorbike, for anyone that doesn't know. In order to do that, you need to be licensed to, you know... Ow, that was loud, Windows! when you're like running, I'm doing a render, and the like render complete noise is like the window's like dong, and that just like just destroyed my left ear. But yeah, you need a full license up until like race bike capacity in order to do that. So I'm in the process of getting that license, which is a fairly lengthy process. But it's super cool. It's super fun to ride those bikes that are extremely powerful. And yeah, they're a lot of fun. I would highly recommend that to anyone who is a fan of bikes. So yeah, it's been busy. It's been a busy few months. I got back from Evo.
What are you buying?
Like, Jesus, like 4 months ago almost now, and it feels like I've only been. It still feels like I've only been back like a week. It's ridiculous how fast the last few months have gone. Right, so we'll rocket launcher the shit out of it, because he is a scumbag. And yeah, from there on, it's Krauser, and then the really shitty, you know, like whatever you call it, the mic segment, and that's pretty much it. Pretty much end of the game, and I can start that handicap run. Yay! Although I need to finish Psyops first. I was looking at my blog earlier today, and I think there was my last post on it was an update about you know that series, and I think I've only completed like 3 games since that point. Oh, you fucker! Damn it. I know better than that. But yeah, I think I've only completed 3 games since doing that last update. And that update was in, like, February. Ooh, that was close. Although, like, to be fair, I think MK kind of had a really... I don't want to say negative, but, like, playing MK had a massive impact on that. You know, I put a lot of games on hold, you know, to travel and compete for MK. So now that I'm not doing that, I'm hoping I can get to it a bit better. That said, I mean, it's taken me like, what, 3 months to get through Psyops, which is like a 5-hour game. Where is he? You bitch. Even at this health, I'm pretty sure that's still a one-shot. You son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm ready for you. Oh yeah, I can pick that up. Sweet. That moment when you want to play a classic RE, aka RE3, but you can't find your PS1 power cable. Ah, man, that sucks. Download them on PS3, man. That's what I did. Because, that's another thing, too, actually, on the subject of playing the older games. I have a load of PS1 games. I recently went through, like, all of my physical game collection and, like, organized them and, you know, did all this shit, like, made a true catalog of what I've got, because I've got a lot of games. And I picked out the ones I wanted to play, and I got it all set up, got everything ready. I had one TV that was of a spec where I could actually stream, like, you know, PS1 games through it, because a PS1 output signal is different from PS2. You know, you need a fairly old TV to do that with. And I only had one, which could actually be, you know, registered through my capture gear and recorded and all that other, you know, all that other bollocks. Recording old games is a hassle, man. There's a lot of crap that goes into recording old stuff. And that TV, like, worked, because I used that to do Dino Crisis 2, which is a PS1 game, obviously. So, you know, I got the TV out and was like, yeah, I'm going to play through all these PS1 games. You know, I had Tony Hawk, I had Alone in the Dark, I had them all locked and loaded, good to go. And the TV died. Like, I don't know why, but, like, the TV just didn't work, which was kind of heartbreaking, because I really wanted to play those games. And yeah, like, none of the monitors I have will, you know, pick up a PS1 TV signal. You know, the monitors, they're way too new for that. So that really bummed me out. So yeah, like, I got my PS3 set up. I recently ordered the Deadly Premonition Director's Cut, and I started that last night. I'm going to play through that again, because I really like that game. And I actually got around to getting the Ico and Shadow of Colossus HD collection, and I'm going to play through them on PS3. And bringing it back around to why I mentioned PS3 is I have a habit of rambling. Yeah, I was looking at my PS3, and I have all the old school Resident Evil games on there, and was really happy. I was like, yay, got all those games. I don't have a PS3. I mean, you can probably get one pretty cheap now, right? Surely, like, used PS3s, I can't imagine are very expensive. Although you'd need a... you'd need an account, wouldn't you? Like, if you, yeah, that's a good point. If you don't have a, if you've never owned a PS3, is your PS4 account, like, you know, you fucking dick. Like, I tried to shoot that. Yeah, is a PS4 account, like, backwards compatible? I would assume probably not. But, yeah, because, like, my PS3 account is pretty much dead. Go away, you fuckers. Yeah, my PS3 account's pretty much dead because the email address that is actually assigned to that you know, account is deactivated pretty long time ago. Pretty sure this is the final one of these. And yeah, so like I can't do anything on that account anymore. But fortunately, it doesn't invalidate like what you've got. So I've still got like the PS1 games I downloaded. I've got Crash Bandicoot on there too. I've got Crash Bandicoot 2 and 3. And if you don't like Crash Bandicoot 2, you're just a bad person, really. Like you're just a terrible human being if you don't like Crash Bandicoot 2. Yeah, so would I. Yeah, like I would assume it works because it works the other way. You know, like you know, PS3 accounts. You know, they work on PS4, so I don't see why not. Oops. Yeah, Crash Bandicoot 2, man. That's a great game. That's a series that, like, I keep wishing they would kind of do something with, but I don't really know what they could do with it at this point. Because, like, 3D platformers, you know, they don't really light the world on fire, do they? Wait. Which is a shame, because 3D platformers are awesome. Well, when they're done right. You know, I was going to do all of this, but I forgot how boring this is. I only really wanted to do it for the money, and I kind of, you know, I don't really need that money. Oh, piss. So yeah, I think I'll probably just do this one then. Ooh, that was close. Oh, come on. Wait, there we go. Wicked. I only missed one prize. I only missed one target too, so. No. There we go. Oh yeah, you don't get the money until you finish it. Anyway. Let's go and kill Krauser. I don't need those. Yeah, what else have I been playing recently? I've been playing a lot more games recently, just off stream. I've been playing through Dust recently again on PC, and my god, I love that game. I really love that game. That definitely came out when I was working in the industry. It was like 2012, I think. And at that point, I was very much week to week. You know, I had like about 5 or so days with the game, and that was pretty much it. Man, I love that game. Been playing through the Steam version, and it's a beautiful game. Absolutely love it. Magnum ammo, which I don't need. Is it first aid prep? Oh no, I'll take that still. Come on, Mr. Krauser.
Getting a bit soft, aren't we?
That was poor shit. Gah! Gears of War 4, you wouldn't be playing on Insane by any chance, would you? Because I can understand that. I had a mini rambling about that just before you started watching. God, that game's a piece of shit on Insane. Like, disappointingly so as well. Like, it's disappointing that, like, a game that in all other areas is, like, pretty damn solid and well-polished is so just, like... get off me, bitch. It's just so lazy in its difficulty structure. It's just like,
getting a bit soft.
Get off me.
Getting a bit soft, are we?
Get off me. I do love the way Leon throws him off. He just like grabs him by the neck. He's like, just throws him over his shoulder. That's pretty badass. But yeah, I haven't touched the multiplayer or Horde mode. I've played a bit of Horde mode, but every Horde mode match I join, like, my entire team just leaves, and it's like, great. Damn it. Yeah, how'd you like that? Yeah, so I haven't really played it much apart from that. I did really like the campaign though. Yeah, I got loads of shit now. Hang on a minute. We can get rid of that. I reload my TMP. And there we go. I want to get Titanfall 2 as well. Man, that game looks sharp. I really want to play that. I didn't play the first one because I didn't have an Xbox. I didn't have an Xbox One when the first one came out. And I think the first one is pretty much nothing but multiplayer, which is like not really all that interesting to me. But just the way that game moves and the way the gameplay kind of comes across in just video, like that seems right up my alley. Like it seems almost like it seems Vanquish-esque, you know. I really want to play Titanfall 2. Now, where are you, Krauser?
Getting a bit soft, aren't we?
Get off. Get off me, son. Right. I never used to shoot them. But... Oh, really? Handgun rounds? Come on. I fucking shot that. Oh, garbage. That's rifle ammo. Oh, no. Krauser's still gonna one-shot me. More rifle ammo. Why would a little drone have rifle ammo on it?
What is it that weird. You're fighting for, comrade?
Ah! Oh, that was pretty goddamn cheap. Where's that gonna checkpoint me? Wow, really? That's a bit rough. Damn. Oh, well. Is that before or after I got rid of my shit. Man, I've actually got a decent amount of health, which Krauser's probably going to take off me. Oh, okay, we're throwing this off. Get off me. No worries more. What about Gears is making you rage? I was just saying, if it's, if you're playing through insane mode by yourself, I understand, because it's spectacularly broken. Rifle ammo? No, that's handgun ammo. Why would you give me handgun ammo? Go away. Bloody robots. Okay, Krauser time. Let's focus. All you gotta do is get him in the sweet spot and fuck him up. Knife the shit out of him. I think it's still one of the best, like, I don't even know if it's an Easter egg, but it's like, it's cool because they have the whole knife fighting thing. It's cool that it's in the game. No, this is where I want you. Oh, you son of a bitch. I think that's going to kill me, isn't it? Yeah, you can't. If he gets you on, like, red health, you can't actually get up from that. Oh. Wait, the Nash is not, Huh, they must have Did you play the beta at all in Mortal? Because I played the beta and like it was like the Gears 3 shotgun. You know, it was like I was one-shotting people left and right. I know that's one of the changes they made in Judgment. Like they really nerfed the shotgun, and like you couldn't one-shot people. But yeah, in the beta, I was one-shotting people pretty consistently. And I've only played one match of Gears 4 online because I'm just not really in the mood to play Gears multiplayer, to be honest. Oh, come on, man. Really? That was garbage. Behave yourself, mate. Yeah. Oh, so... I kind of feel like that's caving. You know, like, people who are new to Gears, I think, you know, really don't understand that it's... Dude! Okay, that didn't kill me the first time, and I fucking knifed him in the dick. Anyway. Yeah, I thought they would have put that back, because the thing about the shotgun is, and I remember, I think it was in the Giant Bomb review for Gears 4, there's a line in there about, you know, people just roll up behind you with the shotgun and kill you, you know, the same as they've always done. And while that is not entirely false, it's not the shotgun that is the factor there for Gears, it's map control, you know? Map control is what is important in that game. That's what enables people to run up behind you and shotgun you in the face. The fact that they're using the shotgun is irrelevant. They could do that with the chainsaw, they could do that. They could do that with the pistol if they really wanted to. You know, I just think Gears has a lot more strategy to it than, for some reason, most people seem to want to admit. They're like, oh, you just run up and shotgun people. There's no strategy. I fucking dodge that. You know, there's no strategy to that. And yeah, there is. Like when I played, the one match I did play, I didn't even really know the map, but the maps in Gears are very, I feel very kind of, very simple to figure out. It's easy to kind of get the feel of the map, and you just, you know, you control the choke points, and you control the spawns, and that enables you to sneak up behind people, or just out-duel them with a shotgun, and seriously mess them up. Right, hang on, I need to concentrate here, because I'm fucking wasting time. I dodged that! Come on! Hey Danny, what's up, man? Paid $100 to point-blank people and have them run in like Zorberg. It's depressing. I just got the standard version of Gears. Okay. Concentration time. It's time to focus. Because this twat is wasting time. Yeah! That actually worked, thankfully. See, this is the tricky part, is like when he gets into this is where he's just attacking constantly. It's kinda hard to get him to whiff where you can actually hit him with the knife. That's got way more range on it than you think. Shit, I didn't want to do that. I've been playing too much Advanced Warfare. I tried to dash backwards then. I fucking dodged that! Come on! What is going on here, dude? Yeah! Try and kick me, bitch. I will fuck you up. I don't know what's going on there, man. I am fucking hitting that dodge, and it is just not working. hey, Sphere, what's up, man? Green is over here. Yeah, he does insane damage on this. But yeah, I don't know what's fucking going on here, man. There's only so many ways you can hit L and R trigger together, and I'm just getting killed. So fuck this game. This game's clearly broken. It's obviously never my fault, you know. It's clearly the game's fault. Like, come on. Right, okay, Krauser, you're getting my tits now. Ugh. There we go. Fuck off. Nah, mate. That's not gonna fly. Dodging that shit. Yeah, there we go. See, this is what you do. You don't try and be calm. You just be a madman about it and fucking run up to him. Get tripped up, but we're gonna dodge that because we're pro. This is where you need him. You need him in a corner. Yeah, bitch. Yeah. Thinking you're good with your... Take that. See? First time. I'm so good. What a dick. Yeah, well, obviously it's not my fault. The torque mode is really good, though. Yeah, Gears is pretty good, Danny. Gears is... to be fair, Gears is Gears. Like, Gears 4... if you like Gears of War, you will like Gears 4. It's a very... That's not a knock against it. Like, it's a very, very well-made game. But it's Gears of War. Like, if you like Gears, you'll dig Gears 4. I'm assuming you finished it, by the way, Immortal, because... I don't know if I'm reading way too much into the ending. God, 7 deaths on that motherfucker. I don't know if I'm reading too much into the ending, but did the ending, like, allude to something pretty amazing? And I feel like I'm the only one who's thinking it. I don't know. But, yeah, it seems like everyone else is like, oh yeah, you know, the ending wasn't that great. And I was thinking, like, yo, did you not, like, get what that means? You know, that pendant being a certain person's pendant? You know? But yeah, I seem to be the only one who made that connection. So. Right. Now we've got to wait for Mr. Mike here to wait like an hour to show up. Should really have the TMP out. I mean, yeah, if you're not a fan of third-person shooters, I can't really recommend Gears more than... You fucker! God, like, everything just... virtually kills you. I mean, have you played any of the other Gears, Danny? Cause, like, if not, then, yeah, again, it's pretty easy. Like, if you haven't played any of the others, you probably won't like 4. Yo, that was your face. Boom. Hey, Pharaoh. How's it going, dude? I shot him in the face, like... yeah, did you like Gears 2? Say, if you like Gears, you'll probably dig 4. Mike, can you please kill this turret? Hey, the meat pie. It's not... I wish it still was morning here. That would be great. Hello, sir. And this is why I saved so much rifle ammo, so I can kind of cheese this bit too. Wait, and he gave me more. Get back in there. He said you could come out. Okay, where's the dudes? Are you at the military supply base on NGV? Ooh, yeah. What difficulty are you on? Well, I totally missed that guy's head, but I'll take it. Alright, let's get out. Come on. Let me seriously. There we go. Alright. Fuck you. And you. And I know there's another one of you up there. There we go. Whoops. You still do the podcast. No, Danny, we did our last show, a while ago now, actually. Yeah, because I think, of the kind of main, of the three of us, I know Gabe's still playing, MK, but, I really didn't like the patch that they put out. I really, really didn't like the changes that they made to that patch, that was pretty awesome. That patch was exactly what I was hoping it wasn't going to be. It wasn't a balance patch. It just, you know, it just buffed characters that didn't really need buffing. nerfed, like, you know, it didn't just nerf characters, you know, it absolutely destroyed characters that, you know, didn't need that level of toning down. The system-wide changes, again, like, I really, really didn't like it. So yeah, I've kind of pretty much stopped playing MK, and the scene in general, like for the UK, is kind of dead, really. I mean, there are people that will probably tell you it isn't, but the MK, oh yeah, 2-for-1. The MK scene in the UK is absolutely dead right now. So yeah, we kind of did one last show, and then that was it. But we'll probably be back for other stuff and shit. I'm not sure why this chapter is in the game. It's a very good question, Pharaoh. It's a very good question. It's okay, I suppose. This chapter's only a real pain in the arse on professional. Other than that, I think this chapter's fine. But yeah, it is kind of annoying. It's like pseudo third-person shooter. But yeah, like the changes to MK are a bit whatever. So, way more rifle. And they really fucked up some characters in that patch, man. Like the changes to Venomous were, oh man, I don't even want to get started on that. So dumb, so stupid. Let's go. So yeah, probably gonna be it till Injustice too. I don't know. We might do something for. Like a Christmas show or something, like another movie commentary one. I'm actually surprised how much people seem to enjoy those, because they're just kind of something we do for fun. Like, they're just something we do to have a laugh. But yeah, like, you know, people seem to enjoy them. Right. Fuck you. Oh, this segment really fucking sucks. A Magnum would be lovely here. Fuck off. Yeah. Didn't see that the first time. He's still shooting at me. Yep. Where the fuck did that come from? I did not want to use that one. Where did... okay. Oh, I bet it was the guy down there, wasn't it? Oh, no. Run. There we go. You gotta love how Mike still hasn't killed the goddamn fucker on that main turret. I knew it. I kinda had a feeling that was gonna kill him, but I should've gone for the headshot. It murdered Devorah. Yeah, I don't know about... what did they do to Swarm Queen? Oh, yes, yeah, Swarm Queen got hit because of the stamina change. What else did they do to Devorah? I feel like they did more than that. The stamina change, of course. She can't... I mean, to be fair, I don't think that's that big of a deal. Granted, it is in the grand scheme of Devorah, but, like, you know, not having, like, you know, safe looping mix-ups is, you know... Die. Like, you know, that's not really a thing to complain about, but... I just feel like that, because in the whole stream, they were all like, oh, you know, we want to keep the, you know, the idea of the character in mind and all that bollocks. And then they go and, like, completely destroy what makes Venomous Venomous. And it's like, yeah, you guys really didn't understand how this variation works. But yeah, the nerf to Swarm Queen's pressure, like, the overall nerf to stamina, is... I don't think it's actually that bad. I think if you get hit while running in, I think it's a really good change, because that makes running in a little bit less stupid. But I feel the opposite end of that, it just makes the characters with far-reaching normals that much more obnoxious. So, of course, Scorpion's pressure got hit pretty hard due to that. And his pressure was already hit pretty significant. But yeah, I just feel like it's a... For everything they do, it's like one step forward, like, you know, 2 to 3 steps backwards, you know. I don't really feel like they... Don't shoot me. as I said, they don't feel like balance patches to me. Balancing is not like throwing the baby out with the bathwater, you know? That's not balance. Balancing is, you know, careful adjustments, not like tipping the game on its head. So. Ooh, need to catch up with the chat. Killer Instinct is really weird. I've completely forgot about KI. I haven't played KI in ages, actually. I haven't played it since before Evo. I need help turning into a ninjutsu main. In what regard do you need help? I haven't touched KI in a long time. I really would like to play more KI, but again, it's just time, you know, only so many hours in the day. Right, piss off. Can you actually hit this guy? Whoa. Can you get the guy? Hang on. Yeah, you think I forgot about you? How did I miss that shot? Oh, fuck. That probably should have hit me, but... did I say that? I meant throwing the baby out with the bathwater. Assuming, you know, like... You know, you take the baby out the bathwater, and then you throw the baby out with the bathwater. You know, you never heard that analogy before? Yeah, you know, basically, don't be hasty. There we go. What's another one? There's probably more analogies I can think of. But yeah, that's basically what I'm getting at. You know, balancing something is not like even Alien, who definitely needed toning down. Like, nobody would have been like, oh yeah, Alien's fine, bro. But like, they destroyed Alien. Like, they absolutely destroyed that character. That's not balance, you know? Balancing a game is not just absolutely decimating a character like that. Did that kill that guy? Yeah. And yeah, you know, he definitely needed toning down. He dead. Ah, fucking old games. This is probably the only part of this chapter that I truly hate. Like, although granted I'm playing through with a way smaller life bar than you're supposed to, but like, this part of this chapter with the default health bar is so annoying. Alright, let's get rid of you. Get rid of you. Too many failed cancels on telly. Notice games tend to always swing too hard in one direction. Yeah, they do. I mean, NRS do, for sure. What did they do to Alien? Oh, man, I'll have to check the notes. But they made, I think, his regular overhead flip's now a mid, and I think they made it more minus. The EX one, I don't think, has armor anymore. It still launches. The delay on regular Tarkatan was completely nerfed, was completely removed. They added hurt boxes to all his tail stuff, which is fine. Like, you know, that should have been there to begin with, but it's still, you know, it still affects the character with regards to everything else. I think he got an overall damage nerf as well. Acidic definitely got a damage nerf. What else? I checked the patch notes on that one, Danny. They altered Alien drastically. You know, to the point where he's not even remotely the same. What are you trying to do with the teleport cancel chat box? Because you shouldn't really be using that outside of the option select, unless that's what you're referring to. Because, yeah, Mike, you're a little bit late. A little bit late, mate. Yeah, like, teleport cancel is one of the biggest bills in all of MK, actually. Like, oh, you know, you can make his teleport safe, just cancel it. It's still minus 10. People just don't touch that. Right, let's get out of here. On his regular mix-up. Yeah, on his usual mix-up strings. I'm pretty sure they made it a mid. Like, don't quote me on it. I haven't read the patch notes in ages since it got patched, basically. So, but yeah, they really changed him a lot. Oh yeah, he's still got forward four, but I'm pretty sure that's slower. A lot of the mix-ups were made slower. But yeah, the teleport cancel by itself is actually punishable, Chatterbox. So if you're playing people that know that, you know, they're going to blow you up for that. It's just something that you very rarely see. You know, very few people blow that up. Granted, it's not easy to do, but it is possible. Oh, by the way, who hosted me? Cosmotic. Is it Cosmotic? Yeah, Cosmotic. Thank you for the host. I almost missed that. Yeah, it's a weird patch, man. I think, like, Lao got pumped up a lot in the patch. I was like, hey, remember when Lao was super good? Even though he was still pretty good. Like, let's make him kind of stupid again. Like, yeah, because that's cool. I was going to ask about Cassie's B&Bs, because they altered the stamina thing, didn't they? So I'm assuming, because, like, she literally couldn't combo you without stamina. So, you know, that's a change to her that's, again, like... Whatever. What else did they do? Tremor is now kind of a powerhouse. That was another thing as well. Like, the universal armored launcher change was fucking dumb. Granted, it promotes better play overall, but people definitely had had this false idea that every single armored launcher in the game was plus on block, when in fact. No, it fucking wasn't. I think there was two safe armored launchers in the game. I think it was two. You fucker. Yeah, there was two. There was two safe, like, armored launchers. Like, there was two safe armored launchers in the game. Most of them were either straight up punishable, or, you know, negative enough to where, like, you could at least do a mix-up or something. Like, that's a huge bill. And I don't know why that stayed around for so long. What are you referring to there, Danny? The armored launcher one? Yeah, like, there wasn't... You know, people just act like all the armor was safe. And it's like, that just wasn't true. And more so to the point, plenty of people pointed that out, you know? Like, plenty of people were like, yeah, that's not actually the case. But, yeah, like, people just repeated it and repeated it and repeated it. And, you know, I guess people didn't know any fucking better to test things for themselves, so. Are you kidding me? How many shots is that guy? There we go. So, yeah, people just believed it. And were like, oh, yeah, you know, MK, that's the game where all the armor's safe, right? No. No, it isn't. And yeah, basically that's kind of what did that. That's another thing actually. Nerfing, taking away armor on Scorpion's wake up teleport. Fucking retarded. Beyond retarded. And the two hit armor. The two hits of armor to certain moves. It's like, why have you done that? You know, like, again, contrary to what pretty much everybody bar Liu Kang players would tell you, breaking armor wasn't that easy in MK. Scorpion's 1-2-3 string, one of the best strings in the game for breaking armor. Unless your armor had to be about 17 frames or slower to reliably break armor on wake up. But again, people don't test it, people don't know, people don't care. And now you have all these changes where people are like, oh, what the fuck, man? And shit, oh, I thought that was going to kill me. You have all these changes in the game, and, you know, people are freaking out, and it's like, well, if you guys had actually tested stuff, because on paper, this is what people wanted, you know? If you're NRS, and you're paying attention to the forums and the chatter, this is what people wanted, you know? Apparently, this is what everybody wanted. And, yeah. I rest my case on the people crying about everything. What were they? Goro's punch walk and... Whoops. Goro's punch walk and Tremor's low shatter, I think, were the only two, like, 100% safe armored launches in the game. I'm pretty sure they were the only two. But, you know, the the thing that was put about was like all the armor safe. Oh yeah, yeah, and they made like yeah, and there's like just safe kind of single hitting stuff as well. Like, what the fuck just hit me? This bit's going awful. I really need to stop talking about it. Okay. Go away. He's not dead, is he? No. I really don't like how I can hear so many crossbow bolts coming at me either. That's very worrying. Shit. Man, how did I like played like shit in this section? You son of a bitch. I really hope there's not a crossbow guy back there. There's one in front of me. Run, run, run. Just run away. That's what we're doing now. Pro strategy. Just run the fuck away. I feel like they followed me. Oh yeah, yeah. Katana had her like, Katana had like another 5 minutes of fame, didn't she? I remember that. Something about balancing. Either devs listen to the masses, or they listen to the people who actually tech out the game. Yeah, I think.
Wait.
I mean, it's obviously a hard thing to do, but I feel like if you made the game, I honestly don't feel like that's much of an excuse, you know, because that says to me that you don't actually understand your own game. Like, for example, if someone was to say to a developer of MK, especially anyone that had something to do with the actual moves in the game and is responsible for monitoring that stuff. If someone was to say, this game's full of safe armor, like, they should be able to say, no, like, yeah, no, it isn't. Immediately. It's like, nah, no, it's not, mate. Like, there's two. There's two in the game. You know, there's two safe armor moves in the game that launch. It's a bit of a stretch to then say, oh, all the armor in this game is safe. But you know, like, prominent players in the community, they scream it, they shout it, and they repeat it, and repeat it, and repeat it, and repeat it. And people that unfortunately just don't know any better, listen to those people. And yeah, you know, there you go. Oh hey Yamcha, what's up man? They should have got all the top players to go up to NRS and have a discussion to see who needs buffs and nerfs. That's the thing, Danny. Like, I don't necessarily agree with that. Top players are gonna want their character to be good. You know, people who travel, you know, with the goal of making money, they are going to want their character to be good. And this is kind of leads into another thing that we've talked about a bit on the podcast, and me and Gabe have spoke about it quite a bit. You know, people, it's kind of a fallacy. Most people don't actually want a balanced game. People say they do, but they don't. Because when you hear people complain about just having to think in a matchup, like, oh, I can't just run my meta one and destroy this guy. You fucker. Ashley, come on, let's just get out of here. Yeah, that's kind of exposes that, you know? Like, it's like, you don't want a balanced game. Like, I've played people that, you know, you play, say, like a 5-5 matchup, and I think Gabe, I think it was on an episode of the show, and I think it's one of the best ways to put it, and I don't think many people caught on it. Gabe made the point that a lot of people overlook the fact that a 5-5 matchup is actually supposed to be hard. Like, that's an even matchup. If you are playing a matchup and you feel in control most of the time, you know, you've got news for you. That's a matchup in your favor. That doesn't necessarily, you know, hate to burst people's ego, but sorry to break it to you, that might not mean that you're just really good. It might mean that you have an advantage in the matchup. They've never understood the right... Yeah, I mean, yeah, Chatterbox, yeah. They buffed Martian Manhunter, for fuck's sake. You know... like, yeah, they buffed Martian, you know? Like, come on, people. But yeah, most people don't want that. Most people don't want a balanced game. Which is a shame. Because, you know, you have this almost, you know, propaganda-like attitude of people like, oh, you know, it needs to be balanced, it needs to be balanced, it needs to be balanced. Whereas what they actually mean is my character needs to destroy the entire roster and I'm the only one allowed to pick my character. That's actually what people are talking about. So, that's kind of my thing on, at least in the NRS scene, from what I gather, that is, that seems to be a pretty common thing. Infinite on the SNES days. Yeah, man, that's totally balanced. I mean, but that's the thing about, and people that have been around since the MK9 days will probably remember that, you know, there were people that defended Cyrax. There were people that defended Cyrax's combos. It was like, oh, he needs it. For anyone that, like, didn't come around from that, like, that's where that comes from. He needs it was what Cyrax players used to say about his 100% combos. He needs it. That's become, you know, a meme almost, but that was said. You know, he needs it, man. And, you know, it's just kind of stayed throughout, you know, all of MK, you know, all of MKX, which is a real shame. There's so much gender pushing in that scene that it's hard, you know, if you're new to the scene or you're kind of getting into it, it's hard to look past that. You know, you have people like Cowboy saying Shinnok is, like, you know, low tier almost. And, you know, with the thing with Cowboy, like, it's hard to know when he's joking sometimes. Yeah, it's just weird. Very surreal. It's very, very weird. And the NRS scene's the only one I've been kind of involved enough in to notice that, you know. No 8-2s. I agree with that. I think that's fine. You know, but, like, and that's the other thing. A balance doesn't necessarily mean not fun, you know? Like, Tekken's pretty balanced. Tekken's fun as fuck. And guess what, people? There's safe launches in Tekken. Yeah, people didn't know that, did they? There's safe launches in Tekken. Unreactable safe launches, I might add. Whee! But yeah, I agree with that. Like, if you have a matchup that is... Although, I mean, I think the matchup number is relevant. I think people get caught too much on that. But I think, you know, it's not hard to determine whether a matchup is, you know, like, significantly in one character's favor. And you need to look at that and think, okay, why is this so much in this character's favor? And sometimes that's not easy to identify, you know? Sometimes you need to play the matchup a lot. You know, you need to grind it. You know, you do need to grind the matchup. Yeah, man, the electric. I was more referring to his forward 3, though, because that's an overhead, and it launches, and it's safe, and you can't see that shit. But yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, like, it's funny, though. There's, you know, that was... I mean, there's so many, like, catchphrases, almost, from the MKX era. Like, all these safe mix-ups that launch. You know, that shouldn't be in any fighting game, ever. And it's in plenty of fighting games. Yeah, I think that's another thing, too. Like, I think a lot of people don't, you know, give NRS credit on that Yamcha. Like, they made, like, a massive effort with this game. You know, there's a lot of variations, there's a lot of unique stuff, and for the most part, the game's actually pretty well balanced. You know, there's not that many. And that's another thing, leading on to, that I think more often than not, people confuse, like, a game being bad with them just not liking it, you know? Like right now, I don't particularly like MKX. Like, I'm not a big fan of the way it plays. But I wouldn't call it a bad fighting game, you know? It's different. And I think, again, that's another thing. If a fighting game is different, people are like, oh, this game sucks. And it's like, no, it's just different, you know? It's not bad, it's just, you know... you hear it a lot, like, oh, well, in Street Fighter or in Tekken or in insert any other fighting game here, this isn't this way. And I think, well, guess what? This ain't fucking Street Fighter, is it? Says Mortal Kombat on the case. So, I'm going to play some Geometry Wars. Right, let's... How long is that going to take to update, do you think? But yeah, so that's pretty much it for that run. This has almost been like a podcast episode, really. It's just, there's only me on it. So, yeah, that's pretty much that run. It's a very fun run to do, one I highly recommend. You know, the smaller case makes it pretty cool. Oh, man, how do you get to your games on? I hate the Xbox One dashboard. I absolutely hate it. How do you get to your game library? One guide. Achievements. Is it? Ah, there we are. Yeah, TYM's pretty bad, Danny. Yeah, I kind of recommend just staying off TYM. Yeah, TYM is fucking horrible. Like, yeah, Geometry Wars. That's true, Chatbox. That's a very, very good point. Yeah. Not many fighters have that mass market appeal. So yeah, that's a very good point. For the benefit of those that can't read the stream, Chatbox's comment is as thus. NRS games are the only ones that fighting games sell to non-competitive players. So TYM has so many people dipping their toes into the FGC, and it's just everyone realizing what's what. And that's a very good point. You know, you have a lot of people that I think, through no fault of their own, really feel they have, you know, a very deep understanding of the games. And it's a shitty thing to have to tell people, but you know, you think, no, actually you don't really understand what's going on here. You know, sorry to break it to you. And more often than not, the reaction you get from that is, oh, fuck you. Which is a shame. If the reaction you got from that was, okay, tell me what I'm missing, people would, you know, grow in terms of knowledge a lot faster. But unfortunately, people don't do that, do they? Oh, it was, man. Xbox, the vanilla 360 dashboard was the best. We need to be serious about that. The Blade system was awesome. I love that. Your streams are usually like podcasts, to be honest. But, you know, that's a good point. They probably are, because it is just me rambling to myself for like an hour. So, yeah. But, hey, you know. Yeah, when was the last Soul Calibur? Whoa. Okay, don't look at the stream. This is one game where you do not look at the stream chat while you're trying to play, but I'm breaking that rule. I think everybody is at a certain point, if they're honest with themselves, Danny. I was like that very early on in the Ninja Gaiden days, you know. I was young at that point. And you know, I think in some ways, the worst thing you can have when you're young is any form of adoration or you know credit. I was you know pretty big-headed in that like first year or so of NG, and then you realize that you know people, you know, that's not cool. You know, that makes you a twat and it makes you someone that people do not actually want to follow or listen to. So, you know, you should learn not to be like that, you know. And, funnily enough, actually, I've been PMing a guy back and forth who's been picking up Sigma, who's been picking up Ninja Gaiden Sigma. He's been, really grinding mission mode, and he's recently broken 50 million, which is, like, a massive milestone, when you're, whoa, you fucker, when you're new to that game. And I think that's a prime example. Like, if I'd have stayed like that, he wouldn't have been in a situation where he thinks he could PM me, like, you know, 400 or 500 words at a time, and I'd actually respond. Because he'd be like, oh, you know, this guy's an arrogant, you know, knob. He's not going to actually help me. And you should do that, you know. You should help people. You know, be humble is basically what I'm getting at here, you know. If you're humble, people will be just naturally more inclined to interact with you, you know, because they know you're cool, and they can just, you know, come up to you and be like, hey, you know, you're pretty good at this game, I'm having trouble with this, can you help me? If your response is, oh, get good, bro, then, you know, that's going to wear thin on people pretty fast. Oh, by the way, did the stream title actually update, guys? Because, yeah, we're kind of past the point of being able to look away from the screen. Oh, we're gonna bomb. I hate having to bomb. Using bombs is like cheating. Ah, this game, man. This game is just fantastic. And old. I was going to say they don't make them like this anymore, but this game's like only, what, 10 years old? 12? 2005. The launch game. So good. Bit of crowd control here. Whoa! Whoa! I was gonna say I need to look at this. I bet like loads of people are stopped watching. This is not really a spectator's game. Fucking red guy. I hate red guys. Although it's funny, like red guys are actually the easiest they ever will be in Geometry Wars in this game, because the shield they have actually goes away in this game. For anyone that's not like super deep into Geometry Wars, the little lines you see in front of those red guys are actually a shield. And your bullets can't get through it, but it actually goes away. Like it's a passive ability that is on a timer. So like they have the shield for a few seconds, and then they don't have the shield. And in Geometry Wars 2, they made it so that it's a permanent shield across a certain part of their body, which is granted smaller, but they always have the shield. So you can't kind of outmaneuver them in that same way. And that didn't change in 3. And I think they are the same way. Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna bomb there. And yeah, I think it was the same on the Wii version. Oh, that was stupid. That didn't kill that red guy, did it? Motherfucker. God, I'm meant to burn so many bombs. Yeah, and they made it so that they always have the shield, which is like super cheap. It's basically what I was trying to say there. You son of a bitch, I knew that was there. Okay, stream, sorry. Who the hell is EC Lion? I have no idea who that is. Have you ever thought about going to a speedrun event for NG Black? Do they exist? Unless it's been changed, I think my record is still the record, isn't it? If you know of someone that's set a faster one, please let me know, because I'd like to see that. But yeah, I think mine is. And that's something I'd love to go to. I'd actually love to do like a live, Awesome Games done quick or something for NG. But I don't really keep up with that scene. So I don't often, you know, I never know when they're happening. By the time I know, you know, everything's kind of locked in. Okay, yeah, it's a tough game to play while talking. Yeah, I don't really know when they happen. And again, it's a time thing. Like, I haven't even been able to do one Master Ninja speedrun yet. And I've been back from Evo for a while. And I really want to get back into that and try and get the time down for single segment Master Ninja. But just time, man. It sucks. You know, you've never got enough of it when you want it. Shit. a speedrun event in general would be really cool. To do that would be awesome. I would really like to do that, and that's something where, like, if I knew I was going to do that, I could actually put in some time, because I've never really put in time for a speedrun. It's always been like this would be a cool idea, I will speedrun NGB. It would be cool to actually have a reason to, you know, really practice and get like an optimum route down with all that, you know, with more than just my general knowledge of the game, which is, you know, granted quite high, but I never really put a lot of time into speedrunning it, so why have I got so many black holes? Oh, that was close. Have I still only got one bomb? Man, I've been burning through bombs. I can hear a red guy. I love the sound effect when the black holes explode. I hope anybody's not epileptic watching this. Fucking red guy. Ooh, that was close. I love the sound effect of like getting a new bomb or a new life. That's such a good sound effect. What are we looking at here? Have you seen the Nintendo Switch? Yeah, I have. I thought it was shit. That's your fault, Yamcha. I'm blaming you for that death. Yeah, I have seen it. I think it looks really cool. I don't really... It's probably not something I'm going to be super into, but the idea of it is really interesting. I really think it's a good idea, but it's contingent on a few things, you know. I think the battery life is huge. I think price... Oh, fucking hell. I think price is significant too. Which again kind of leans into power, like, you know, how powerful is it? If it's essentially a Wii U that you can, you know, I suppose a better way to look at it is like, is it a portable 360? You know, is that basically what it is in terms of power? Because if it is, that's kind of awesome, but also kind of reductive because you don't really need the power for that. So I'm really interested to see what they do with that thing. I think it's a great idea, but you know, great ideas don't always pan out into... There we go. Into, you know, huge successes. Because, you know, a lot of, you know, prime example, a lot of people thought the Wii was dumb. And, you know, look how that turned out. The Wii did okay. I need to see you do another Master Ninja... I need to see you do another NGB Master Ninja speedrun. Please, the first one. I'm working on it, Immortal. I'm working on getting time to do it. It's, yeah, I really do want to do another one of those. I like this game too much to disrespect it by leaving. Yeah, Geometry Wars is so addictive. Yeah, I think it is still the fastest time. But you're buried underneath more popular runners. Yeah, I know. I just don't care, you know. That's kind of what I meant about... It's an aspect of it, because I get a lot of PMs about that. It's like, oh, why don't you submit your run to X, Y, and Z? And why don't you do this? And why don't you do that? And it's like, you know, not in a disrespectful way, but I just don't care, you know. I don't have... funny, Big Owski is actually one of the people who grills me the most about this, which is funny. You know, I'm very... I guess I'm content, you know? Like, I don't feel like I have anything to prove when it comes to NGB. And one record is not going to really be the difference maker on that, you know? You know, I have plenty of records in NGB, not just the speedrun. But I guess I should submit it to Speed Demos Archive, because I know they've made their submission process a lot simpler. I was going to do it originally, but they still wanted me to use, like, uTorrent and all that bullshit, and like, I'm not torrenting stuff in, like, 2013, because it's 2013, you know? Who the fuck uses torrent sites anymore? Okay, see you, Danny. Thanks for watching, man. Shit. That's your fault, Danny. It's fine. He's not in the stream anymore, so he doesn't have blamed him for that. But, yeah, I should really do that, I suppose. But, yeah, I know there's more popular runs, but, you know, I've always been one of the opinion, I guess, like, you know, it's out there, you know. My run it's out there for people to see. I didn't see that blue guy there. If people want to watch this, you know, if people want to watch those other runs instead, fine. You know, more power to you. I'm not really that fussed. This is a bad idea! Shit! that was a bad idea. Master Ninja will probably bring in a good audience. Yeah, that's true. That's true. That segmented run. Perimeter Snake spawn, man, so cheap. That segmented one was a lot of fun. But I watched that recently. I say recently, it was probably like a year ago, you know me. But I watched it back again and was like, oh, this is terrible. Like, I was looking at, you know, I thought, oh, you know, you don't need to do this, you don't need to do that. And I think that's the big downside of not, like, you know, not staying current with the game, is I do stuff in NGB every now and then, and I do it with, you know, kind of just what I can remember about the game, and that's never enough, you know, because then I always go back and watch it, and I think, oh, you know, this would have, you know, if you'd have just put, like, a little bit of time into prep, you know, this could have been a lot better. So that's kind of what is delaying me going back to it as well in a lot of ways. Because I want to do another normal speed run. I want to actually get that time down on single segment. But I don't want to do it until I can actually, you know, put prep time into it to make it really good. I don't want to beat the time by like 3 seconds, you know, and then post that video and be like, yeah, new record, man. Because I know people do that, and that's something that a lot of popular runners tend to do. You know, they will do a speed run and it's like 1 hour 53 seconds, and then their next video is like new record 1 hour 50 and 1 second. It's like, well, yeah, it's faster, but no one gives a shit. It's 2 seconds. I'm not watching that. Like, you know, that's something that I don't really understand. For me, I think, you know, post it, you fucking bitch. I think post it when it's a significant improvement. You know. At least that's my 2 cents on that, I suppose. Pull a Shia LaBeouf and just do it. Yeah, you're right. I should just bloody submit it, really. Yeah, I really should. Oh, really? Okay, I don't know. But, yeah, I'm not, I have no idea what's going on in these communities anymore. It's one of those things, I think, once you kind of fall off, you know, once you kind of fall out of it, once you kind of fall out of the loop, I find it hard to get back into it, you know? Get rid of that. Oh, I was really hoping for a black hole spawn there. You bastard. But, do any of you guys know, actually, who organizes, like, those, like, the, you know, the speed run marathons for, like, the summer, like, you know, like, summer games, Don't Quick and all that stuff. Is that Speed Demos Archive, or am I way off with my assumption there? This is a stupid idea, but it looks cool. Okay, more. Well, I should probably get Jump Jaws 3 for Xbox One as well, because I love Jump Jaws 3. I don't know when to call this, because I could just play this game all day. Oh. That's the only problem, though. Then you've got to deal with the fallout of black holing people. Oh shit. Give me another black hole spawn. Ah, damn it. That was good though. I thought it was, but it was a red guy. Oh man, that's not good. Shit, it's never a good time when you have to like bomb back to back. You should do that, Sphere. Because NG is... Playing NG is never a bad idea. NGB is always fantastic. I haven't... God, when... I'm trying to think of the last time I played it. Been one. You know, it's like... It's like a classic movie, you know? It's like, what do I want to play? I'll play some NGB. Shit. More or less organized by Speed Demo. Okay, cool. But 90% of the people from there. Okay, yeah, I'll have to, something I need to look into. Because it would be cool. It'd just be cool to go to an event like that, you know? It'd be cool to, see the speedruns live. I say it would be. Novelty might wear off pretty quick. Whoa, that was close. Look at that shield, man. That's bullshit. Ah, I should have bombed there. That was panic bombing. Look at all these red guys, man. This game would be like, I mean, this game would be so much less stressful without red guys. But if you took away the red guys, it wouldn't be the same game. Whoa. I say the red guys are annoying. The fucking green guys aren't much better. And the purple guys aren't much better than the bloody green guys either. If you know what I mean. God, look at this! Red Guy City. I got a bomb. You son of a bitch. You could go to the event and do another fight, stick one. Oh man, my hand would fall off. Like, that's a really fun way to play NG, but god damn, it is uncomfortable. It's really uncomfortable. I play it for like half an hour, and like my hand is cramping so bad. It is a cool way to play the game, though. My hands hurt watching you do that. Yeah, it's not fun. I know, man. And that's the worst. Like, you bomb, you go on a bombing run like that, and then you die, and it's like, oh shit, my multiplier just got reset. Fucking, I hate Red Guys. What are we at? 2.6 million? Man, I can just keep playing. I did not see him. Son of a bitch. Right, well, okay. I should have just died there, actually. Because I don't know, just spawned. Okay, that was a lot of snakes. I might just play this out. This is not a great run. Look at that shit, man. Alright, this is probably going to be all she wrote soon. Little blue guys and red guys with no bombs, you are kind of fucked. Shit. Snakes! 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 Fucking snakes. I actually killed the red guy. I killed the red guy and died on the fucking little blue thing that was behind him. That sucks. That's what I needed, but it's too late. Yeah, it's too late. I still think it's kind of hard to pick up when I have the volume turned down, but the sound effect of when you spawn and kill an enemy with, like, your spawn shield is amazing. It's my favorite sound effect. That's a lot. That was 2.8 million before I had a corner diamond spawn. That's massive. You never really want those past a certain point, because they're just death. Like, if you get them, like, past a million or something. Oh yeah, there we go. So that's it. What is my best score? I think like 4. Yeah, 4. Yeah, my best score is actually on PC, I think. I got like 5.8 on PC. Look at my friends list, man. Friends list. They need to step up. They need to play more Geometry Wars. I'm gonna get my get. Oh, cool. See you later, chat box. Use you, man. Yeah, you tend to get to that point, I think, Cosmo. You do get to a point where there's very, very few, if not one or two games you want to really kind of, you know, put effort into. So, anyway, that's going to be it, guys. Next stream will probably be PsyOps, hopefully, because I really need to get that finished. Man, look how big Halo 5 is, man. 87 gigs. Jesus. That's like a lot of copies of Geometry Wars. It's a hell of a lot of copies. But yeah, PsyOps next, hopefully, and then probably another RE4 handicap run that guy sent me, because I really want to try that one out. So I will catch you guys later. Thanks for tuning in to this podcast, essentially. I'll see you in the next stream. Take care.